Bad Omens, The Grey. You know, I'm super stoked for this entire album. We've checked out, I think, a few songs on it so far, and I've been a fan of most of them. Yeah, I'm super stoked to see it, but I'm also super stoked to see them live in Spokane, because shout out to my boy Tyler. Dude, this is crazy. This is, like, actually crazy. One of my friends was going to the concert, and then I saw that one of my subscribers was going, Tyler, and I was like, hey, you know, I would go, but, like, I'm moving right now, and I don't have a ton of money to just, like, throw around. And he goes, oh, cool, I bought you another ticket. And I was like, you did not. He did. He straight up bought me a ticket. So shout out to Tyler. That's some real shit right there. Bad Omens, The Grey. I'm Jordan Needham. This is J Ham Entertainment, and let's do this. Kind of reminds me of the Bring Me to Horizon riff. Hey, Bring Me to Horizon riff.
Even the scores, and I let it all go fall apart. And every step forward, put a little more sword in your heart, yeah. Looking sideways when I say I'm okay with the past. I'm afraid of what I'm gonna say if you ask. Maybe with too many chances you're out the room. Got everything I could want, but it wasn't enough. Nobody left for me, I talk to nobody to call.
Let's go. We're gonna get hit with the chord. Oh! Oh! Okay. Don't do me like that. Yeah, don't do me like that with the little buffering thing. I'm sorry, no. Was that part of the video? I love the version. Ooh. That progression. Let's go. It's building, bro. Ooh. Let's go. Sing it. Oh, what are we gonna do with the bridge? It's a song where I look for a good bridge, you know, this type of song, so we'll see. Okay. Just straight to the chorus. Oh. Okay. All right. That was Bad Omens. I was going to say Into the Gray, but it's just The Gray. So yeah, I really like what this band has going right now. I understand that, you know, not all of it is like super, super unique. And that I think if you were an outsider from the metal or hard rock scene, you probably wouldn't understand what's going on. But I think if you're somebody who's been listening to metalcore for a long time, I think this is just like kind of refreshing to hear. I know this song in particular isn't super, super heavy, and that's fine for me. You know, I like hearing these sort of spins on making a catchy verse or a catchy chorus and just kind of making it all about making music and not about making metal, if you get what I'm saying. You're using the music as a way to express what you're feeling and what you want to get off your chest, right? And no, Dr. Seuss is not here, but I did kind of rhyme a little bit, okay? Well, that dude got canceled. So, yeah, I have nothing to do with him. And I think he's dead. No, he's definitely dead, okay? Maybe it's because he got canceled. No. No, it's not. He got canceled after he died. That's crazy. Damn. I think the company pulled the books down themselves, so it kind of wasn't even about public backlash. It was just like the company being like, hey, we don't want to be racist anymore. And, you know, a lot of people were like, no, no! I don't know why we're talking about Dr. Seuss. Anyways, back to the music. But yeah, I think that that's one thing that I really appreciate about bands like The Plot and You, for instance. Their last two albums have been really just like emotional from the heart. You can tell that they're using music as a way to express what they feel. And that is what really inspires me. Like, as an artist myself, I'm a 3D artist, and you can check out my portfolio. Shameless plug. Check out my portfolio in the link below, or just follow me on Instagram. You'll be able to see all of that stuff. But it's just really inspiring to see people, you know, using something like metal or hard rock as just a way to express themselves instead of just using it to write hit songs, or not even just hit songs, but just like songs that will resonate with their fan base. It's kind of hard to explain. I think if you're an artist out there, you kind of get what I'm saying, where it's like, you know, there's this, you're torn between, you know, wanting to make stuff that pleases everybody, but you also want to be able to like dose it with what you're feeling and the shit that's in your head. And of course, the best artists out there are able to do that. It's difficult, you know. I think especially in metalcore, when there's a lot of albums that we react to here where I'm like, you know, this is good and I like it. I truly do. I love the breakdowns and everything. And then just like a few days later, you know, I'm already kind of not listening to it anymore, just because that's just me. I'm not saying it's bad. It's just because it doesn't inspire me. And so I like what Bad Omens is doing here. I think it's from the heart. I think they're just trying to experiment, be really creative in their own right, you know. And I'm not saying it's super revolutionary, but I just love to hear it, and it's inspiring to me. So can't wait to see them live again. Shout out to Tyler, if you're watching this video, you're the guy, man. You the shit, man. Okay, let me know what you guys thought of this song in the comments below. And if you want to see me react to more bands like Bad Omens, hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so you never miss when I upload. And as always, I'm your boy Jordan Needham. This has been J Ham Entertainment, and I will catch you next time.